Here we go.
150 miles northeast of Dutch Harbour.
Let's go fishing.
On the Saga.
We delivered 62,000 pounds. Now we're headed out to start our second trip. Hopefully it's still hot when we get back out. Now we're headed out through the pass. The weather looks good. Says maybe I run into a 3-foot chop when I get to the entrance. But Falls Pass is its own animal, as we all know.
After offloading $30,000 worth of cod, Captain Jake Anderson risks navigating Falls Pass, a narrow channel with a shallow sandy bottom. 16 hours can be shaved off the return trip to his gear, but only if he makes it through unscathed.
Wow. Joe.
Yeah.
Can you see those out there? Can you see those waves out there?
Swell, yeah.
That ain't no 3-foot swell.
No, it's not. It looks like an 8, 9, 10 footer.
What the? I checked the weather. Swell height, right there. Waves, 3.89 feet. That ain't no 3.89 feet. Can you see the red can up there? I can't see. God, I'm pissed off now, dude. Could be submerged. I can't see the buoys. It's like trying to read an Encyclopedia Britannica in the dark without a light. God, I hate this path. I've never even been in here with these kind of swells before.
That was a hard one.
Wow. Dude, we just bottomed. Get everybody up.
Roger.
It's gonna be bad. Oh my God. Okay. All right, we made it out, Joe.
We were high up in the water. It's just shallow, there's nothing we can do about it.
We're far from being out of the woods. We hit hard more than once. I need to check the keel. I need to check the rudder posts. And this stuff takes time, but I'm not gonna risk the lives of my men and women and the safety of the vessel. I'm gonna turn and start heading to Dutch. It's a tactical retreat, but this is just a stupid start.
In Dutch Harbour.
Here we go.
On the Saga.
We came out of Falls Pass. It was tragic. We hit the bottom harder than I ever have in my life. Gerard's inspecting the forward holds or anything he can find that he thinks is gonna be a weak spot.
Forced into port, Captain Jake hires a nautical engineer to inspect the underside of the boat to find out if they've merely lost a trip or an entire season.
While everybody's making $50,000 a day, I'm stuck at the dock. And you can see why now Derby is so costly, because it's gonna close at some unknown date. You either fail or succeed.
Maybe I'll just come on for a second.
What's the damage?
All the paint's gone on the bottom.
That's about where it hit.
Yep. And on the rudder skags, on both of them, the bottoms, they're completely polished to metal. It's a sketchy place to cross.
I'm not going through that pass ever again. I don't care. Yep.
Thanks, Gerard.
Okay, great.
Thanks, Gerard.
Yeah.
Turns out that we were really lucky. So, that's it. All right, guys, let's throw them.
Yeah.
Yeah, hustle up.
Jake?
Yeah.
Doing my checks. Looks like you had some coolant in the reduction here. Water or something.
Oh, that's the gearbox.
Yeah, gearbox off me.
If we would have left, it would have pretty much shot our transmission. We'd have been down.
With water where oil should be, less lubrication causes heat to build and rust to form, threatening to seize the drivetrain.
Hold on, guys.
Yeah, Raj.
We can't just sit here for forever. Just do what you can. As fast as you can, Mace, okay?
On the Saga.
The Mason has been working 24/7 to get this thing fixed. Everybody's out fishing, and I'm stuck here. Talk again for something so stupid, something so minute.
After running aground in Falls Pass, but escaping hull damage.
You're just all happy, getting ready to go.
A faulty gearbox threatens to do what the treacherous crossing could not, put Captain Jake out of business.
That bilge is pretty high, huh?
What are you gonna do, Mr.? You're gonna fill the transmission?
Yep, we're gonna put oil back into the transmission here.
We're about there. The only thing that worries me is now, when we start it and run it, how much more gunk is gonna come out.
All right, well, let's fire it up.
Hi, guy.
Here goes nothing.
That's interesting. I don't really like the corrosion in here either.
Hey, Jake.
Yeah.
Right now, after we fired it up and got it warm and stuff, now I'm seeing rust particles come out, which is, I mean, the oil, yeah, it'll block whatever, you know, shoot out, but the rust particles will literally clog it, you know?
Then so. We'll overheat. They could possibly sacrifice a $250,000 engine and a season. But we can't just sit here forever. I'm fishing.
Let's head out. I'll clean it up.
You're not gonna sleep. Somebody has to watch that temp.
Yeah. Well, what is it, 18 hours? All I need is four.
Okay. Let's just fire up the starboard. We'll start going. This is derby fishing. I don't have the choice. It's time to go. Let's do it. All right, let everybody know. Go ahead and throw lines.